Good morning, everyone, and welcome to our General Assembly for March 22. You know, as usual, we get our morning started with good morning as we get our mind energized and ready for the day ahead. So, good morning to you, everyone. All right. In the interest of time, I have to put a pause on that music. Now, this morning, we have with us Ramon Stahl, 26-year-old ambassador for the Lord Jesus Christ. He's a past student of Fernwood High School, where he, for the hat of head boy student council representative for 4 consecutive years, and vice president of the United Nations Club. While at Fernwood, he was also actively engaged in the choir, 4-H and drama clubs. His current passion is French, thus he's completing a Bachelor of Education in Modern Languages at Shortwood Teachers College with the intention of promoting the teaching and learning of French in Jamaica. He also holds a Diploma in Foreign Language Education from the University of Clermont, Harvard, France. I hope I pronounced that right. At Shortwood Teachers College, he functions as the president of the Modern Languages and French Debating Club. Ramon continues to be guided by the words of Muhammad Ali, "Service to others is the rent you pay for your own room here on earth." And it is his desire to also evangelize in French territories. Help me welcome Ramon Stahl, who will share the word with us this morning. Good morning, Ramon.
Good morning. Are you hearing me clearly?
Yes.
Awesome. Okay,
all right, so it's now over to you now.
Okay, thank you, sir. Let me share. Okay, good morning again, everyone. I greet you all. Greet you well. My last time at Fernwood High School was in 2018. So it is indeed a privilege to be sharing on this platform in your devotional exercise this morning. Today we're focusing on the topic of excellence. And in a time like this, you know, we're faced with many challenges, and it may seem as if we are not able to do whatever we are doing excellently. But I'm here to remind us this morning that God is in control and excellence is in him. Now, the scripture that I want to focus on this morning is taken from Colossians chapter 3, verse 23. And it says, whatever you do, work at it with all your heart as working for the Lord, not for human masters. That's the word of the Lord. Today we're faced with so many challenges, yet still we're expected to stand out. We're expected to do whatever we do excellently. And we see that the times are continuously changing. And some of us may feel as if we are fighting for survival. I'm sure that's how I'm feeling even this morning. Daily we have to balance our personal lives, family time, studies, work. And most importantly, in this season, we have to try to balance being safe. And I know it is not easy. Even with our education system at this time, some new announcement by the Prime Minister yesterday would maybe, you know, trigger some fear, some anxiety. You know, we may feel tired. But I want to remind us this morning that with God, all things are possible. And though we're living in what I call abnormal times, we're still able, with God, with the help of God, to effectively carry out our duties and to reap excellent results. The scripture this morning is telling us that whatever we're doing, do it with all our heart. If never a time we have to do whatever we're doing with our heart, it is now. Because we're trapped in a situation where we aren't even able to share same physical space as we used to. And so even teamwork is challenged. Even the assistance that we may receive from others, it is almost impossible in these times. But in spite of that, God has made a way and he has provided for us still. This morning, we're able to share in devotion on this platform. Isn't he wonderful? He is surely wonderful. As we focus on the topic of excellence, I want to remind us this morning, I want to say to us that there is this false narrative that excellence means perfectionism. But I want to say to us this morning that excellence is not a set level of quality of or perfectionism, but it is an ever-changing dynamic or process. It is about growth and maturity. And so we may fail today, but tomorrow we will improve on that. We may not be able to withstand some of the challenges immediately, but with the help of God, we will overcome at some point in time. And so the Lord is telling us this morning that excellence is first achieved when we commit our ways to him. The scripture says, as working for the Lord. We have to commit our ways to him firstly, and that's how we will achieve excellence. He's also reminding us this morning that he wants our best. So though we are faced with the challenges and we may not know what to do sometimes, when we put our heart in it, in whatever we're doing, the scripture tells us in Ecclesiastes chapter 9 and verse 10, that whatsoever our hands find to do, we're to do it with all our might. And so I want to encourage us this morning that now is the time for us to put our heart in it. And that's how we will receive excellent results. Jamaica is depending on us. The Lord is depending on us. We are depending on each other. And so we cannot give up now. The Lord is also reminding us this morning that whatever we do, it should be dedicated to Him first. Sometimes we focus on excellence as achieving all that we can in this world without thoughts of those that will be impacted positively or negatively by what we do. And so we continue to go on. But I want to tell us this morning that excellence through God impacts positively those that are around us. And so we need to focus more on pleasing God. We need to focus more on finding the solutions through Him to achieve what we are set out to achieve. The words of God tells us that we are to let our light shine before men, that they may see our good work and glorify our Father which is in heaven. And so the work that we're doing, it will have an impact on those who are around us. It will have an impact on us as well. So what shall we do? We need to rely on God. I know sometimes it is very difficult, and it may seem as if the challenges that we face are the hardest. It may seem as if it doesn't make any sense we continue. The things we want to achieve, they are impossible. But this morning, the reminder is going out to us that when we put our heart in it, then we are able to overcome. When we allow God to be the center of it all, then we will receive the excellent results. God doesn't want us to settle for less. And so there is no room for mediocrity. Our excellence in God speaks to the fact that what we do today will not be the same that we do tomorrow. It is not the same that we did yesterday, because we would have reflected on what we have done yesterday. We would have identified our weaknesses and we would have improved on those. We would have also identified our strengths and we would build on those. And so excellence is a continuous process, and it is easily achieved when we commit our ways unto the Lord. An ancient philosopher, Aristotle, says, excellence is never an accident. It is always the result of high intention, sincere effort, and intelligent execution. It represents the wise choice of many alternatives. Choice, not chance, determines your destiny. And so, what is important also is that we identify that the choices we make in life will determine whether we reap excellent results or whether we will remain stagnant. It is as simple as that. Our excellence is as a result of high intentions. We must identify that we're working towards something. There must be a goal in mind. There must be something that we want to achieve. There must be an aim, what it is that we're working towards. When we are aware of this, then we will put the necessary steps in place. And so it is a sincere effort. We will make the necessary plans and we will commit all these plans unto God, asking him for his guidance, his leading, knowing that he is able, he is faithful, he is just, and he will grant unto us the desires of our hearts. Excellence is as a result of intelligent execution. We need to have strategies. We need to reflect. We need to think carefully about what we're doing. And when we have figured it out, then we need to put it to action. And so excellence can be achieved when we execute intelligently. Look at us now. Who would have thought that we would be faced with this situation? It is frustrating at times, but what are we going to do? We have to adapt to the times that we're living in, and excellence can still be achieved. I share an example with you this morning that when we had our first lockdown as a country, everything went online so suddenly. And for many of us, I didn't have the necessary tools to adapt to the online medium immediately. And I had to figure out, what am I going to do in this situation? I'm in the heights of my studies. It is almost exam time. What am I going to do? And so I had to put plans in place, even if it meant that at that moment, I would have to visit somebody's home to access internet, to do what is necessary to achieve excellent results. And I can tell you this morning that when the work is put into what we're doing, when we put our heart in it, excellent results will be achieved. At the end of that semester, my GPA was higher than even the other semesters when I wasn't faced with this challenge. And so I'm telling you today that when we commit our ways to God, when we put our heart in what we are doing, we can achieve excellent results. The bottom line is the choice that we make. Aristotle said, excellence represents the wise choice of many alternatives. Right now, we may be faced with many alternatives. Some of us may be at a crossroad wondering what step to take. What am I going to do? But this morning, the choice that you make will determine the result. We must understand that excellence can be achieved through the Almighty. He says to us that he is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we ask or think, according to the power that works in us. Excellence is in God. And so if God is in us, if God is the center of our lives, then we must, it is imperative, we are going to achieve excellence. Excellence is in God. He is able to do exceedingly abundantly. There is nothing impossible with God. Let us this morning think about these things. In the midst of the crisis, in the midst of the challenges, when we go with God, the results will be fruitful. We can think of David who faced Goliath. But he said in that very moment that, Goliath, you come to me with your sword with your spear, but I come to you in the name of the Lord. And so the only way we can truly achieve that which we set out to achieve is when we go in the name of Jesus. Excellence is in God. And when God is in us, when God is the center of our lives, when God is the focus of all that we do, when we commit our ways unto him, then we will receive excellent results. This morning, Philippians 4:13 reminds us that we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. And as I close off this morning, these encouraging words, I want us to take a moment to just reflect on the words of this song.
We worship you this morning, Lord. We declare together that it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus, at the center of it all. Sing it. Jesus at the center of it all. Jesus at the center of it all. From beginning to the end, it will always be, it's always been you, Jesus. Jesus, and nothing else. Jesus, be the center, say, Jesus, be the center of my life. Jesus, be the center of my life. From beginning to the end, it will always be, it's always been you.
Amen, amen. Jesus, be the center of my life. Jesus, at the center of it all. And so whatsoever we do, as we hope to achieve excellent results, I want to remind us once more that it can only be achieved with Jesus at the center of it all. Let us pray. Eternal Father, our God, we thank you this morning for the gift of life. We thank you, dear Lord, for sending your Son into this world, not to condemn us, but that through him we may have life abundantly. We thank you this morning, dear Lord, for this opportunity to be gathered in this fashion to hear your words. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for the Ferncourt High School family. This morning, O God, as I come before you, I pray, loving Lord, that you will overshadow us this morning with your love. Lord, I pray that you'll cause the spirit of excellence that is in you to fill our hearts. I pray, loving Father, that you'll continue to prosper our plans. I pray, loving Father, that you'll give us the strength and the courage that we need to go through these challenging times, knowing that if we put our trust in you, if we believe in you, and if we obey your will, then we will succeed. Loving Father, I pray for every staff at this institution. I pray, loving Lord, that your Holy Spirit will continue to guide, continue to protect them. I pray, dear Lord, for the students and parents. Lord, I pray that your Holy Spirit will continue to protect, continue to guide them. Help us all, dear Lord, through these challenging times. We need your strength. We need your guidance. We need your protection. And we know that if our faith remains in you, then we will be able to overcome. So, loving Lord, this morning I place the rest of the day before you, the rest of the week, that as we reflect on your words, our hearts will remain blessed and we will remain confident, knowing that if we allow you to be the center of our lives, if we allow you to be the center of everything that we do, then we will indeed receive excellent results. Take the rest of the day in charge. Be with us continually as I leave everything in your hands and tell you thanks. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you very much, Mr. Thomas.
Thank you, Ramon, sir. Wow, in your calmness and your delivery, see that God continued to use you to reach out to others. You reminded us this morning that when we put our heart into it, we display the spirit of excellence. There's no room for mediocrity. All right, at this time, we need to build on our strengths and we must continue to commit our ways to the Lord. Thank you for sharing the word with us this morning, and I hope that the persons who are listening now or later on our YouTube channel will reflect, despite the challenges happening around us, but we must see ourselves as overcomers and overcomers through Christ. All right, before you go, Ramon, I want you to do something for me. All right, I want you to read our vision. You're supposed to remember this from your time here at Ferncourt, but I just want to remind our stakeholders of our vision, mission statement, and our core values. So I will display it on the screen, and you will read.
Okay.
All right, good.
Vision statement. Ferncourt High School is involving all stakeholders in acquiring knowledge, developing skills, and building character to function globally. Our mission. Ferncourt High School is a dynamic institution committed to instill in its students the need for excellence in academic and extracurricular activities, positive attitude, environmental awareness, high moral values and skills to function in this technological age. Ferncourt High School's core values. Core values for in court step up, safe, tolerant, eco-friendly, positive, Ubuntu, professional.
All right, and our theme, the year of persistence, resilience, and excellence. And this month, we're focusing on the aspect excellence. Next month, we start over again in April with persistence, and that's how we're going to do it until the end of the year. So thank you, Ramon, for reading the mission, our vision, our core values. Fern Court, step up, that's our core values. Step up, we are safe, tolerant, eco-friendly, positive. And we really have to be positive during this time as whatsoever what is happening around us, we have to be positive. Ubuntu, we have to look out for each other. It's an African word, and continue to display professionalism. All right, some announcements. As you would have noticed or realized from last night that we're fully back online. So we'll be online for this week, Monday to Friday. And we'll also be online next week as well, up to Wednesday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Now we break for Holy Thursday, and then we'll now go into another midterm break. But I will talk to you more on Friday about what will happen next week. For the grade 11 students, you know that 11 NCO, URT, and sixth form, they will not be asked to come in this week. So they will also be online at this time. So I'm reminding the teachers, the parents, the students that we are fully back to online learning until further advice. I know that some of you are having challenges with the use of the internet and so forth, but we have to think about our safety, our health first. I was listening to Ramon as he said that last year when country had its first case and he, where he was, because he's currently studying, he didn't have the resources and he had to make a way. And it might sound hard, but I think at times we have to try find some other creative means to get certain things done. So I know parents, it might be hard and so forth, but I believe that we have to just find a way. We have to just know to find creative ways. I know the teachers at Fern Court, they will upload the work and everything on our Google Classroom. But at some point during the day or even the week, I will encourage the students to go on and catch up what they can catch up and do some other reading and so forth, because education is important. And if we are going to be able to move forward as a country, education is going to play a critical role in your development. And we, all of us come together, make our country a better place. Unfortunately, we reached this stage as it relates to COVID-19, and it's because of persons not cooperating and following the protocols. We have to ensure that, yes, you might not display the symptoms, but you can affect other persons. So I'm reminding you and encouraging you to follow the protocols, wear masks at all times, stay 6 feet apart. Well, we are in the vaccination process now, so when the time comes, we deal with that. But we must understand, parents, students, teachers, those who are watching, that we have to protect ourselves so that we can protect other persons in our midst. It's now 8:42, but we're not going to end without our national anthem. And then we start our classes. So have a wonderful day. I will be back on Friday for more, as I have another Fern Court Pass student who will share the word with us on Friday.
pleasure, love, and loyalty of my heart, the wisdom and courage of my mind,
the strength and vigor of my body,
the service of my fellow citizens. I promise to stand up for justice, brotherhood, and peace.
Work diligently and creatively,
with generosity and honesty,
so that Jamaica may under God
increase in beauty,
fellowship, and prosperity, and play her part in advancing the welfare
of the whole human race.
Of the whole human race. Of the whole human race.
All right, so have a wonderful day, everyone. And I see you back on Friday for another General Assembly. Stay safe and all the best for the rest of the week.